This we've seen a little bit of an identity transformation, right, Nick, with this Boston team, and it's going well.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, I feel like we're finally past the Big Poppy, the David Ortiz era. As much as we love you, Big Poppy, this team has moved on. They have an identity now with Hanley Ramirez right in the middle of that lineup. Obviously, Mookie Betts, probably one of the most electric leadoff hitters in the game. The young core of the Boston Red Sox, man, they do look good.
They got a great lineup. You know, 1-9 line drive hitters and the addition of J.D. Martinez. You know, money well spent. This guy brings protection to guys like Hanley Ramirez. And Hanley Ramirez right now is playing like he wants to win a championship. And they need that from him because this guy's a superstar. But sometime he's laid back. You have to push him a little bit. But ever since he got injured last year and they told him he might not have a starting position coming into camp, this guy has worked his butt off and gotten back to that superstar status that he's capable of being any the other week.
This 14-2 start, best in baseball since 2003. That was the Giants. They went on to win 100 games with the Red Sox winning tonight. And still, they have some players who haven't been able to contribute fully because of injury in Bogarts and Pedroia.
Well, yeah, I mean, those guys aren't even in the lineup and they're doing this sort of stuff. I mean,
they're deep.
We talked a little bit about it earlier. I mean, what happens when Dustin Pedroia does come back? I mean, does he get back in the lineup? Is he a guy that's the heart and soul of that team, in my opinion? But, I mean, it doesn't seem like they're needing him at this point.
They don't need him right now, but I'm going to tell you right now, this guy plays hard. He's a guy that you want in your clubhouse and you want on the field. He's going to fit right in because Alex Cora is the manager now, and he knows how to keep everybody healthy and keep everybody fresh to get in and contribute to this team and winning. They'll be fine when he gets back.
Yep, and a sizable lead on the Yankees, although it's April in that AL East, more on the Blue Jays chasing them. Toronto, did they get overlooked?
I think they're the biggest surprise in the AL so far. We knew Boston was built to win, but those two aces they got, the closer they have, and that strong lineup. But no one talked about Toronto. You know, getting rid of Joey Batts, getting rid of Encarnacion the year before. People thought they were rebuilding. But no, Chaparro came in, and what has he done? Win. He went out and got Solarte, Diaz from St. Louis. These are winning baseball players. You know, these guys do the dirty work, but they also got Justin Smoke, who has become a young superstar in 2 years. I mean, the guy hit so many home runs. They're led by this guy, Josh Donaldson. I mean, he's an MVP. We know what he can do. But Pilar out in center field catching everything. And you got the young kids coming up. So these guys are motivated to win because you got two young, five-star superstars coming up for the minor league soon. So these guys know the urgency is now to win. But the Blue Jays, with the pitching staff they have, I talked to you earlier about it, they got four great starters. You said, great, but if you look at their numbers over the last 3 years, 91 wins and 61 losses. Excuse me, 92 wins, 61 losses with a 3.74 ERA. That's a great stat.
Boy, he just went out of Toronto's speech there.
So I'm telling you, man, guys, he loves them, man.
If these guys continue to pitch, these guys continue to grind out wins, you never know what his team might be. And then at the beginning of September, because I'm telling you right now, these are winning baseball players.
You're saying they're a playoff team.
They are capable of being a playoff team. They got a strong staff. They got one of the great young closers in the game. It's going to come down to middle relief, and they got to continue to score runs consistently.
Yeah, he's right. I mean, they have been overlooked. There's no doubt about it.
Well,
I mean,
and for April, we'll see. The over-under in Vegas on wins this year was, 80.5? They're going to win more.
But I think they discounted that. Their top four starters are 92 and 61 last 3 years with a 3.70 ERA.
Best starting combined pitching after the Red Sox in that division. I think it's probably better than the Yankees, at least, you know, based on what we've seen.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, you've got a lot of guys that are playing extremely well right now. Guys that are kind of under the radar have really stepped up and done well earlier. Josh Donaldson's hurt, and they're still putting up these numbers. Third best run differential in baseball. I mean, as much as we were arguing earlier, I didn't know the pitching staff was as good as they were.
And they got a veteran catcher who's calling those games for that.
Yeah, you got big Russ Martin behind the plate, man. This guy's done this for a long time.
All right, all of Toronto is applauding.
Won't be surprised. Won't be surprised they found their way back in the playoffs.
All right,
so for the pitching staff, last 3 years, their top four starters, 91 and 62 with a 3.74 ERA. That pitching staff will keep this team in games, and that offense will find a way, led by Josh Donaldson. Watch out for this team. Watch out for this Blue Jay team and make a lot of surprises this summer and win a lot of ball games.
Yeah, what are you, running for office in Canada? Kevin Burkhardt will be here
tomorrow night. That's right. That's my boy. There you go, KB.
Kevin tweeted this. Can you read that about the Big Hurt? He loves the Blue Jays.
In the Merlot suit. No. You're right. No, these are the tight pants. But I'm getting in shape, bro.